Good-sized crowd of 38,293 enjoying a beautiful day here in Pitt Stadium. Dave Sims and Rick Doc Walker, great to have you with us on the Big East Football Television Network. All colors starting to break through here in Pittsburgh. It's just lovely.
Look at the kind of defense that Pitt Panthers have played without Tom Tumulty. You know, their leader who is out with sprained left knee. So this has just been a terrific effort on both sides of the ball, really. Both defensive coordinators ought to be proud of the effort. And offensively, the kids have hung in. I mean, it's been good defense that has negated some big plays.
Just one touchdown, one score in the third quarter. That 63-yard pass from Ryan DeGels to get Pittsburgh to within 7. Pitt showing blitz, the draw, not there. Maybe a yard. Kent Roy Barber, straight up the gut. Out of Selleck.
I like it. I love it, man, when you get to a point where your adrenaline is flowing and you're pumped up and you're getting off blocks and you got your buddies flying in to make hits and it's just tough to run the football.
Brian Bauman.
This is a money kick here.
Sure is. 39-yard field goal attempt. It's 4 for 6 from this range. What? Can he pick it up and go? Let's see. He got the bounce. What a bounce. That's Tom Barth.
Can he get the block?
He's going to go. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. He got the bounce, and he had the speed.
He had that elephant on his back, and he got a block. Oh, boy, I love the defense line, but with the football, there's nothing like it.
Why pity the guy and gal that got out of this place early?
Boy, Dave, this has all been worth the wait. Pretty good snap. The kick looks pretty decent. Then you're going to see an extension and a block. You know, and now it's like a fire drill. Looking for him. Boy, he gets that. Now he's thinking, can I make it? Can I get there? All of a sudden, that monkey's on his back. Oh, no. Gets the block. Pretty good. He's in the end zone. That's the defensive line for three.
He switched angles. That's what did it for him, plus the block. And Don Dillon has seen a 31-6 lead. Right down the tubes, Merrick, for the tie.
UT has not been automatic.
Penalty flag. Too much time on Pitt.
Oh, boy.
And he missed the kick, too.
That's just not been automatic operation.
So we've got...
Play of the game. Offense.
We've had 2 blocked field goals returned for touchdowns. Harold Kidd for West Virginia to make it 10-0. And Barnt, 53 yards to bring the Pitt Panthers to within 1 point. And Merrick, who's generally automatic, but only missed one coming in, has been a shaky kicker today.
Boy, he took a bad exchange. He thought that was true.
We're tied at 33. You might not have thought this could happen when it was 31-6 Mountaineers, but that's where we are. Early fourth quarter, back at Pitt Stadium after these messages. They're whooping it up for good reason. Pitt Panthers have come back to tie it at 33 because Tom Bart scored from 53 yards out. It happened because Chad Askew,
boy, he got up.
4, oh, man. Kick.
Talk about a vertical jump. He could have been in Midnight Madness last night. What a sky. Look at Barber, man. He's chugging along. Boy, that's good stuff. Now let's watch this. This snap was, boy, what? Those are hands. Those are hands. Good operation.
Boy, Ralph Willard, the new Pitt football basketball coach, may say, hey, can't ask you. My man.
I got to bring him out. I got to at least give him a look.
That's it. Martin to kick off. Hits it high and deep. Banter pull at the 3. Nowhere to go. Down at the 19. Fired up hit. Special team. And some really good hitting. John Jenkins, number 15, was in on the stop. The initial stop made by number 53, George Mooring.
Aren't you glad you stayed?
Pittsburgh.
Get that guy a job.
The Pitt yell leaders say, aren't you glad you stayed? Tell you what, get on the phone and call somebody because we got 14 more minutes to go.
For homecoming, you just can't ask for anything else. It's just nice.
Pitt's defense has been outstanding. They shut out West Virginia in the third quarter after giving up 17 and 16 in the first half. Mountaineers going to throw it. Johnston looking for finding Vanterpool. Nicely done, but now it's broken up. Mosley on his back breaks it up at the 35.
Yeah, nice grip. Boy, isn't it amazing what confidence can do for it? This is the same club that last week against the Syracuse Orange when would rip apart. I mean, they were beaten in every facet of the game.
Gave up 600 yards.
Yeah, look at that, 600 yards. Watch this. See, that's a good catch. That's a good strip.
Johnston on a down right now. One for his last seven passes.
He's still dangerous. You know he's got it in him. That's the thing about it, boy. You underestimate this kid, you're in trouble.
The pressure gets out of the way. Running for his life, it gets out of bounds. Jared Miller had him and went too low.
Yeah,
number
boy.
55, he had him.
Jared like to get that one back. He'd like to get that one back. You don't get, it's so hard to get there. When you get there, you got to finish. Got to finish.
Jared Miller in for Tom Barton. Got to still be winded right after 53 yards. On that blocked return. Turnover score 4-1 Pittsburgh.
Look at how time of possession has evened out.
Mm-hmm. Total yards, Pitt at the edge there, 362.
Both teams down though in terms of rushing the football. This is their bread and butter. And I think the team that can get back to that will win this football game.
Third and nine. West Virginia more success on third down from the gun. And a whistle beforehand. Had the blitz on McCray.
This is too much time.
Inside.
Play the game. Offense.
Yeah. Third time we've seen that. Why do you have a situation like this in a 33-all game, fourth quarter? Pitt's had it twice, now West Virginia once. Why the difficulty?
Well, one thing, you don't want to rush into a mistake, but two, is just bad huddle management. You got to get those plays in, rip them out. All you need is one guy to say, you know, hey, Chad, what's it on? That's all you need. One thing, you know, in the huddle. Very important. We don't talk enough about what goes on in the huddle, and now you got to have a really defined leader.
So Pitt defense can tee off now. See Jones, number 67. Here it comes. Underneath. Good ball. Nicely done. Pitt's defense is held again.
Oh, look at Chase again.
Oh, the excitement building in Pittsburgh.
I usually don't even like defensive guys, but I'll tell you this. Some of the linebacker defense and tackle play that I've seen in this league, it's really been impressive. Now watch it. See, that's kind of like a delayed dog. And you get in and get that pop. See, every little thing you can do. Elevation, you know, scratching, clawing. Good defensive football.
Davis with the knockdown. Sauerbrunn hit this one. Mosley back to the 40. Didn't have any help, but he gets it into West Virginia territory to about the 47. Pitt Panthers have a chance to take the lead. 13:40 to go. Fourth quarter, we're tied at 33. We're back after these words from our local stations. After the Mountaineers were up 31-6.
College football, baby. You got to love it.
Pitt in good field position at the Mountaineer 47. Straight up the middle, Chad Dukes. Perkins says, it not gonna happen. Stephen Perkins, 97. James Thomas, number 41, stop Chad Dukes.
Yeah, that's the thing about both teams. That they just don't give up a lot between the tackles. Yeah, yeah, Dick Vermeil back at UCLA always credit the fact that we're going to be tough between the center guard tackle and defensively linebackers nose tackle. That's the core of your football team.
Second and 10. Ryan on the out, look out, closing, great play. Beasley, boy, I saw him coming. Great close, he had about a six-step close and just shut that play down.
Kid doesn't play like a sophomore. But then again, the one thing about it is that you cannot telegraph a pass. I mean, you just can't do it. I don't care who you are, how strong your arm is, you gotta give your receiver a shot.
Tried to go wide side of the field the first time Ryan came into the game. His first pass, first play, and it was picked by Beasley and returned for a touchdown.
Well, Beasley's a keeper. He really is.
They go with the five-receiver look. Jones in the slot, the tight end, bottom of your screen. Flanker screen, Davis.
Well, like
45, that. 40, blocked down the sideline, first down and more. Billy Davis drilled at about the 23-yard line by Aaron Beasley, but a first down for Pittsburgh.
We talked a little bit about the a la Miami Hurricane pass offense, man. Just get the ball in the hands of talented people. It doesn't have to always be a 60-yard pass. Little hitch, little move, stutter, go. And so you get a block come up out right there, you get some help from your friends downfield, and you're moving the chains.
Dietrich Gels with a good block. The ball at the 23-yard line. Davis, four catches, 80 yards. High game at 33. They run the fullback up the middle. Just to show it to him. Just to show that they can run it. Maurice Washington broke just a simple dive up the middle.
He had one, but West Virginia is determined to never let that happen again.
Yeah, 34 yards on the second pit possession for Washington.
Yeah, they stopped that. Well, the key is at JT Thomas. I mean, this guy, both middle linebackers, great linebacker play today, good tackle play. I mean, you can't play good defense without good tackles. And both clubs have got really good production at those positions.
Kent was down 31-6. They're now tied at 33. Ball at the 22. Drop the ball. They play. Loose ball. Oh, my goodness gracious. Look at this. Thomas picks it up. West Virginia takes over.
That's good defense. You take advantage of things. Yeah, it's a bobble snap, but you bobble snap because you're thinking about making blocks and getting to other people.
Billy West is hurt, too. Trying to make the play, and here's the snap. Ryan pulled out too quickly.
Yeah, yeah. Never had it. Then you got to get on it. You know, now it's just there, and boy, boy, boy. The hungry dog will get it first.
Mountaineer fans got to feel a lot better about that. Pitt was going in with an opportunity to take the lead, and Billy West is okay.
Well, you know, it's no sin to play a good football team and have a turnover, but when you lose a field goal opportunity, a chance to win, man, I mean, that's ridiculous.
Pittsburgh,
I mean, the fact that they're tied up is amazing. It's unbelievable. And that's why Coach Don Dealey, he can't afford to leave here with those kind of stats.
And how about Pitt coming into the game was plus one in giveaway takeaway?
Not indicative of their record.
Not at all. Third in the conference and giveaway takeaway. West Virginia from its own 27. Got to get outside. Walker, nowhere to go. This Pitt defense is really playing well. David Sumner comes up with the stop.
Well, we're watching this on both sides. I tell you what, there's got to be a loser in this, but Coach Dunlap, I mean, he's got to be proud of what's going on right now. As we watch Walker again, this is what West Virginia wants to do. They want to run football, but there's just no happenings. No happenings whatsoever. Tell you what, Stressback's got these guys in charge up. I don't know what Chuck said to him at halftime, but whatever he said, I hope he takes it.
Yep. They want to market it, too. Johnston over the middle, overthrows Abraham. He's had about 5 to 6 balls where he's been, everything's been good except it's been too high.
Yeah, I've been a little high, but that time, North Mosley was in good position. That'll force you to extend the ball a little bit. I still believe an interception is going to turn the course of this game.
Yep.
Sooner or later, on the other side, an INT, because they're putting it up.
It's amazing. Turnover story. Pitt's turned it over 5 times. And they came in, as I said, plus one behind Temple and West Virginia, which were plus 5. Johnson, play fake, middle.
Vanderbilt, nice catch.
Big time play. First down, Mountaineers at the 39, covered by Sumner. That's been a great battle all afternoon.
Well, I thought at one point maybe they'd get to Purnell, their tight end, help him out on the third down play, go back to that patented slot move. And you got an up and in. They got an out in the end, rather. And that's a money catch.
15-yard pickup on the day. Vanderpool's digits, impressive.
Sean's numbers are nice.
Fullback. Oh, man, Chapman Cray.
Just forget it. You got to do it, but both sides, you know.
That's a sacrifice. Oh, you're the fullback. Oh, man, you're calling me again?
Now they're just a lot really of slight on the offensive line, man.
They're unloading. Really are.
Well, that's good. This is really nice. See those blue shirts? See that they're lower? The pads are lower. And Johnny Major says it all the time. Low man wins. It's a good indication.
10-10 and counting. 33 all. Pitt and West Virginia. Quick out. Vanderpool, nicely done. Close, just shy of a first down at the 49. Class move by Vanderpool.
Yeah, he's short, but he needs to get to the marker. That's the receiver's responsibility.
Next week, we could be in one of three places, West Virginia, BC, or Virginia Tech. Check your local listings. Noontime start. Look forward to catching you then.
Tell you what, Mountaineers, they're playing a little defense. Hurricanes coming off rest.
That's right.
Woo!
Could be fun.
Woo-hoo!
Third and real short. Johnston takes it himself. Not without Mike Halepin having a say in the play, 94. With Tyler Young also there, number 92. Followed Jay Brooks to get the first down. Johnny Majors. The onside kick was a beauty earlier. They tried a fake punt. That didn't work, but his club, as we talk about, they don't quit. Not in his vocabulary. And his club down 31-6, comes back to tie at 33.
Well, he promised us that he'd open it up. Boy, he's done more than open it up. He's ripped it apart.
As we talk about, they don't quit. Not in his vocabulary. And his club down 31-6, comes back to tie at 33.
Well, he promised us that he'd open it up. Boy, he's done more than open it up. He's ripped it apart.
It's a great offense, too. From this man, Chad Johnston,
gotta
ball
go
for a home run ball. Vanderpool, door set. Any flags? No. Uncatchable. Good coverage. Outstanding coverage, in fact, by Anthony Dorsett on an explosive Rahsaan Vanderpool.
Anthony is growing up in a hurry. He really is. Not easy to follow your father's footsteps. You know, Heisman Trophy winner, great NFL Hall of Famer. His kid's on defense, and he, every week he's getting better. He's physical. You know, he's got all the size and the tools to do some outstanding things here at Pitt.
Anthony Dorsett, 5'11", 190. Junior out of Alaquipa by way of Pierce, Texas. Second and 10 right at midfield. Johnston switching up, hit on the blitz. Here they come. Down he goes.
Yes,
Tyler Young with the sack, his third of the season.
Yes, who? Tyler's gone a long way from playing on the offensive line at Notre Dame. You know what I mean? Making a move, not only from schools, but from positions, and showing you right here, man, that he's nasty enough to get in and get the job done.
Ball back to the West Virginia 42-yard line. That's a big loss. 8 yards on that one. West Virginia 42, clock at 8:35 and counting, 33 all our score. Plays from the outside, deep sideline ball. Abraham, he stopped. If he kept running, he would have been there.
I think he was trying to lure the defensive back to sleep, but I almost thought that was a great play. Let's see if we can get Paul to show us that again. I mean, this was, what a nice look on this. Shotgun formation. Here we watch it, see a little look off, and he gets it up pretty quick. And you watch at the end, and I thought he almost lured Dorsett to sleep on that.
Trying to
sucker him
into it. There's
a little phony acceleration,
right.
And you know what I mean? You get the defensive back to stop. Boy, that was near. That was close.
Try to get some push, too. Get an interference call. Ninth punt by Sauerman. Good snap.
Oh, he got it!
Oh, Billy Davis, look at this!
Can you believe this?
To the 20-yard line, the recovery by number 24, Thad Culpepper. Billy Davis, number 49, with the block.
Panthers are possessed.
Oh, what a game. Don Neely doesn't
game,
know what hit him.
You did game. Oh, yeah. Before you can get it out of your mouth, I mean, the operation is still good. He's going to it right off the foot. There it is, right there.
Oh, yeah, the collision, the scoop. Boy, he scores on that. Oh, he scores on this place goes nuts.
Ball at the 21-yard line. This has been a wild one.
Yeah.
Call somebody, turn them to join in. You still got 8:24 to go.
They got a long way, though. This is no gimme.
And we've seen that. Both defenses have been outstanding here in the second half. Ryan, the pitch, Billy West to the corner. Check that. That's Dietrich Gels. And he gets to about the 17.
Yeah, Billy was out on that play. They're trying to get some speed. Gels, this is the fourth time today they've had him in the I-back formation.
Gels, two long passes, had a good block on a play in the previous possession and a couple of decent runs. They got it to him. They fumbled it. They botched a couple of snaps trying to get it to him, but he's had a good game.
It's going to be a fight to figure out who's clear of the game in this.
I'm telling you. Second down, six. 33 all the score. 8:15 left to go in the ballgame. Ryan does not get it to his wide open tight end, Del Seagraves.
Boy, that hurt you. That hurt you.
Had him.
Yeah, he's talking about the angle. You do want your tight end to get a little flat. You always want to show at least part of the numbers as possible so your quarterback's not an easy throw. Here's we'll take another look. So you get back. He's kind of throwing it out in the flat where he thinks he is, not where he was. You can't afford to waste a play when you're down in the red area. You're
sure
trying
enough
to score to win.
Third and six. Long count, play clock winding down. It's at three. They get it off. And they run off tackle and try to set up the field goal attempt by David Merrick.
West
who has a long of 54. Billy West with the carry, James Thomas with the stop.
Boy, you're talking about blown an opportunity. I mean, let's face it, West Virginia had a lot to do with it. But that little shot to the tight end, that's an easy throw.
It was.
To Seagraves. See, you move the chains, you want to threaten to score. I don't know if 3 points would beat the Mountaineers.
I hear you. This attempt, 32 yards for David Merrick, who's 4 for 5 in this range on the season. The hold by Ryan. Blocked again. Are you kidding me?
Oh, I love this game. I love this.
This is Emmanuel, Charles Emmanuel, down the sideline. Oh, man. Keith Morris blocked it.
Either this is sloppy play or some of the great athletic plays of all time. Oh, man. As we focus in again. Pretty decent snap. The kick is there right off the toe once again. Merrick's got to be thinking, man, I may have to start working out if I'm going to kick here.
We had a blocked punt, now a blocked field goal in successive possessions. Still tied at 33, back after these messages. We've seen enough for about three seasons today when it comes to weird plays, blocked punts, blocked field goals. Attention's been amazing.
All I can say is that Dave Merrick told us he didn't like to run. He better start working out because he got to play some defense. Just some superb athletic plays on both sides of special teams.
That return by Emmanuel. So Mountaineers take over their own 42. Not going to be able to run. We certainly established that theme. And T.D. Moody with a good stick.
Moody's plays some good ball. And that John McCray, he is just been.
How about that? Everything's all even.
How often do you see that?
I tell you, yeah, I can search back long, long way to find a deal like that. No gain on that play. Second and 10.
Sure is.
A lot of people have touched the ball today. Interceptions, block punts, block field goals, long pass plays. Got an out pattern. Vanderpool is. Oh, he dropped it. He had it at the 36. He knew he was going to get hit. He figured he had a chance to stop and maybe turn it back, but he did. He didn't do item one. Catch it first.
He's thinking about, you know, at least getting 1 foot in or not. Let's take another look. Ball over the shoulders, makes the extension. Ball is there.
Oh.
That's a catch and go. There you go. Oh yeah. No, that's just a drop. That's a drop. He's a playmaker, but boy, it doesn't count unless you make him.
Oh, it's a time. Come on, we need you. You're the man. We need you.
Could have been worth an extra hamburger doing chow line, man. We need that catch.
Third and 10 for the Mountaineers. We tied at 33, 6:40 to go. Blitz on. See ya. Oh, Pitt defense, I'm telling you, on fire. Chavis, McCray, they've been marvelous.
Those two guys, man, they're basketball players and the game honors that Pitt wins this. You always wanted to play linebacker. How about being Chavis right now? That's another dog. They have done this now four or five times. Third down, they get an opportunity to come in. They break the backer. They get right in his vision because Chad, again, wants to look downfield. That's good defense. Good hustle. Enthusiasm on both sides.
The fourth sack by Pitt. He came in with 10.5 on the year. Salvin. Oh, baby. Back to the eight. Mostly a valiant effort, outmanned about 8-1.
Boy, big
that punt, 57 yards, a return of 10.
Killer.
John Sauerbrunn, robo punter, 33 all the score. We're back to Pitt Stadium after these messages. Tell you what, great family entertainment this afternoon. 33-all, 5:55 to go in the fourth quarter. Dave Sims and Doc Walker crew with you, and it's been some kind of game. You know how many possessions this is for Pitt? This is number 17.
Working Eric today strong.
Eric Moses, John Rivero getting it done. Stats and spotter day. Looks good. Big play.
Hungry man gets it.
Billy Davis had a shot at it. I don't know if he finally came up with it. Good grief.
And this separates the men from the boys on loose balls. You practice it throughout training camp.
Pittsburgh got it back.
Defensive players do it all the time. Offensive guys, I don't think they practice the fumble roosky enough. Ball on the ground, getting after it.
Take a look from the end zone.
Boy, Pitt is he's little exchange points, little off, but then you get a hit. Boy, that's good defense again. West Virginia. I mean, that thing goes with how you coach it. You coach the kids to knock the ball out, to tackle the football.
Austin Malika came back to get it. Second and a long way to go. Second and 23. Can't afford a mistake here. Going to throw. Gets rid of it. Got a man, Davis. Knocked out of bounds at about the 22-yard line.
Breathing room. We never found out what happened to J.T. Thomas. He missed a few plays early on in the first half.
They've been a force.
Bill Run. Yeah, boy, he's
made a
back.
Force. I mean, they forced that fumble. Ryan now has gone over 300 yards passing. In relief of Sean Fitzgerald. Third down and 8 from the 22. What a remarkable game. 33-all. We're in the fourth quarter. 5 minutes to go. Ryan under pressure, picked. Oh, he should have had it. That was 6 for James Thomas. There was nobody that could have stopped him.
He caught that ball like a linebacker. Oh, man. He'll look back on this one.
Fake, watch your fake.
And again, I mean, I won't take anything away from the performance that John Ryan has had, but if there's one thing, and I'm sure Coach Majors, Ken Carter, everybody will be. You cannot telegraph your pass up Division One lines. You can't do it. I mean, the interception is supposed to be a tough thing to have, not like going to the candy shop.
Cochran, first punt of the second half, a line drive, a wonderful bounce from Pitt. Manchable breaks his man down, gets to the corner. Penalty flag, blocked in the back, no doubt, at the 35. 49-yard punt. A lot of it rolled for Nate Cochran.
Yeah, way to go on the bounce, though. And the food showed some guts.
Sure did.
Illegal block in the back during a return above the waist. A 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
Kills you. Just kills you. You know, we get back to Ryan a little bit, but he can develop that. Just that ability to just look you off a little bit. I mean, he's got a real feel for the position, you know, and he knows where to go with the football, but you just can't telegraph.
Locks in on that first receiver, the primary receiver. They got a barn burner going, too. Nebraska finally got another touchdown.
That defense, though, that's hard to do.
Ohio State.
Dukies.
Duke with a win. Duke in the ACC is now 3-0, 6-0 overall.
Cavaliers.
So the Mountaineers first and 10 from the 23. Johnson's got time. Not for much longer. Nice play by John McCray. Brings him down. Lose five on the play. Fifth and sack.
There is no substitute, my friend, for speed. You can be in the right position. You can have a lot of things going for you, but you got to get to the football. Again, they go back to the play fake. They are content to do this. I think they're going to have to try to establish the run a little better before you can do that. Tom Martin forces the pressure, and here comes Mr. McCray. Can't turn the corner on him. Just great speed.
Back to the 18-yard line and did lose five on that play. Johnston out pattern, nobody home.
Now, this is a shame for both defensive units that ultimately will have a winner and a loser, rather, because these guys,
Don Needle's thinking, my goodness.
Don't forget, we don't have overtime, so at the rate these two clubs are going, it can stay like this. We got 3:53 to go, and we're still tied at 33, but your sentiment is on the money. There's no question about that. And the effort has been marvelous. West Virginia's had 33 points since the 5:25 mark left in the first half. EP and not scored here in the second half. And the gun, pressure over the middle. Benjamin Cole catches, dropped it! Oh, he dropped another big play for West Virginia. Oh. Throws his helmet down. He didn't get it done.
Man. Bad news, you got to go to the sidelines and face Don Nealon after this. Nice move. Oh, boy. Rashawn, super move, pal. He gets the separation. You know, in the clutch deal on third down, that's a money route. He is there, baby. Just couldn't hold on.
Wow. Hit 10 men up at the front trying to go after Sauerbrunn again. Billy Davis got a block.
They might think at some point and get it to the return.
Boy, Vanderpool has had a great day. He's got a touchdown.
Oh, he's a player. He's had two chances now to help his ball.
Third down, you bet. Sauerbrunn, 10th punt. Didn't get it. Not a typical Sauerbrunn punt. Mostly stops the bounce. Bounds at the 40-yard line.
Knucklehead play by
Casper Owitz, number five, nailed a guy out of bounds. And that will cost Pitt. There was no reason to do that.
You fight your guts out for field position. Here, Mosley, he's going to the sidelines. He's trying to turn this thing up. Okay, he's down there. And he's also out of bounds. Now you watch this. You see, this kills you. You cannot have a knucklehead move in the fourth quarter. You got to have plays. Playmakers and smart football players.
On a return team, a 15-yard penalty from the end of the run.
Oof.
First down.
That's a killer. That is an absolute killer, and there's nothing Johnny Majors can do about that because it happened right in front of him. He saw it.
Hey, you got to try. You know. Boy, boy, boy.
Can't say enough about Pitt's defense. They've been outstanding. This play right here is a killer, though, the 15 yards on Eric Kasperowicz.
Well, you know, it said it Rolling Rock open, but then you just score on defense, and it may boil down to that.
Back to the 25, clock's going to start going against Pitt. Pump and go, Jones, he's there. Complete at the 41 of West Virginia, first down Pitt. Ball took forever to come down, but a big play. 34 yards to Dietrich Jones.
Boy, boy. That's the number 26 making the play. Now you got it. See, you see the pump. Buy you some time. He gets a nice up move. Now you find the ball. You keep the foot in. Perfection.
Beat Aaron Beasley on the play.
Boy, it's so nice to see it done right.
Ball at the West Virginia 41.
Going up against Beasley. He's a man, so that's good stuff.
Gels, four catches, a 185. Billy West, good block. They force him back inside, picks up two.
Evan Mayfield came up and he had a collision and a half with Maurice Washington.
That's the way you force.
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, man.
Made Billy West cut it up.
Mountaineers.
Good play by Mayfield, number 30.
Well, it's just an unselfish approach to playing the game. You know, you got to force, you have to do some dirty work on defense, on offense, and some guys don't do it.
Gels to the top of your screen, Davis to the bottom. Second down, bottom end of the box for West Virginia. They show blitz. Ryan, they see it. Looking for a fade. Got a man down there. It's Billy Davis up in the air. Can't get it. Maybe jumped a little too soon. Van Washington covering with help from Harold Kidd. They packed the box on this one. Whoa, Auburn streak lives at 18. They knock off number one Florida.
Terry Bobbs.
That opens the door
For
Nebraska.
Oh, yeah.
And Penn State with the W today.
AP's going to have to make some decisions now, pal.
Third down and eight. It's a beauty here.
Terry Bobby. Gotta love that.
Into the swamp and he wins. Ryan under pressure, looking for shovel pass. And he throws it, gets rid of it, and he flags. No. The intended receiver was Gels, and Gels is getting up slowly. Like he was driven into the turf. He might have a shoulder problem.
Got crushed.
Like they tried a shovel pass. That's exactly what it was, a shovel pass that they tried to make happen right here.
You got a shovel right from Tafoni. You showed him the shovel all right.
97, Stephen Perkins just killed that play.
Perkins has been on, man. Perkins has been on fire. Look at the end of this play. Now, you're going to see exactly what happens to the shovel pass. Oh, boy, that's a little elbow, too. Might be a bone on that one.
Might be. That's a bone. Oh, that's one of the all-time elbows ever caught on video.
Major league hit.
Oh, my goodness.
You see, you put a receiver at a disadvantage. When you're looking for something to happen, you got to keep your eye on the quarterback. Oh, man, good read.
Whew. Dietrich Gels getting up, and he's all right.
He's a man.
Boys back in Erie. The boys back in Erie know they know he can take a punch.
Well, you fellas, you get back and they say, hey, man, hey, you know, we with you. Because you know then, he's a warrior.
He got popped.
Boy, that's a Dick Butkus kind of hit. So you love to see Dick play with the Bears. He'd knock your memory out of you.
And your family. Yeah. Goodness gracious. 236, you better have it strapped on. Cochran, pooching, left corner. Is he going to get it? No, close, but he didn't get it. This has been some afternoon at Pitt Stadium.
What about you? But my VCR is going off a couple of seconds.
We hope for more of same next week at either West Virginia, Boston College, or Virginia Tech. Big East football coming at you 12 noon next Saturday. David Mayfield said, I got a free one here. I'm punching.
Well, great hit.
Wow.
You know, it even makes it better when it's legal, too. It's a legal hit, but boy, it was brutal.
Wow. All right, what's going to happen here? West Virginia's offense has been shut down.
Got to get the tight end involved.
Off for Vanderpool. Pressure, throws it away. And look for Vanderpool.
Ooh. Got away with one.
Pressure by Chavis and Moody.
You know, I hate ties. We had a 17-17 tie back in the Stone Ages against Ohio State back in 1976, and it's just,
does nothing for you, right? Rutgers, BC, easing off Temple a little bit, third period. Tech has regained the lead against East Carolina.
That's a heck of a game.
Johnston, 3 for his last 14. He's had several drops now. His defense, Vanderbilt, has had two huge drops. Barber, nowhere to go. The pursuit hits defense. I'm telling you, this is not the same defense that gave up 600-plus yards last week. And they have been marvelous this afternoon.
No, they are playing as if, I mean, from a team standpoint, as if they all run 4-7 as a defense. They are just enthused. They finally got a break, and they're playing well.
So it's third and 11 inside of 2 minutes.
Imagine what Pitt would be like if they had their players healthy.
You bet. Let's see again. It's picked up. Vanderpool is there. He can go. Let's see. 40, 30, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, West Virginia. He broke one. Salvation for Rahsaan Vanderpool. 81 yards, and West Virginia takes the lead.
Boy, it's nice to see a kid redeem himself. I got to tell you, man, when you drop a couple of like that, you think about it, you want to come back and get it.
What a big play, Johnston to Vanderpool, covering 81 yards.
This takes the win out of the sails. See, he had time. He puts it up real long. Nice separation. At this point, track me. You're just not going to catch me. Referee kind of chips in a little bit. Mosley can't get it done. Still like to see him dive close for the strip. Can't get it. Touchdown. Mountaineer.
Wow. Big play. Bauman for the point after is good. With a 1:32 to go, the Mountaineers up top for 81. Rahsaan Vanderpool. That's about a month for a lot of receivers.
Well, he went from having to wear a bag over his face all next week going to class to where now he can strut his stuff. Boy, good separation, good catch, and this is what wide receivers live for. That pull away, that acceleration where you can hit pay dirt. Boy, that's nice. Let's take a look at Chad. Chad's going, oh my, hey, he got one, great.
And the other thing he's happy too, nobody killed me on the blitz because it was picked up. A nice job by West Virginia. The lineman, Derek Bell, the center, peeled back and got a piece of a couple of blitzers.
Yeah, boy, Jay Brooks has done a great job for him. Hager's been big. Click. That offensive line, it's been tough because it has been pounding.
First score of the second half by West Virginia. Totally shut down by the Pitt defense, and they break one big. Johnston has thrown for 337 yards. And you're right. That's a good point. Does not have to wear a bag around the campus of Morgantown.
Oh, no. Because dunk. You know, you got to go to class, so what do? It's not like you can just hang out in your dorm room all week, wait till the next game. You've got to show up. You know, in the pros, you can go to practice and go right home. You don't have to go shopping or whatever. You can send the wife out. In college, man, you're exposed. You got to show up.
Sauerbrunn, boy, he negates that return. There's no return there. Blasted out of the end zone. Pitt got to respond with a 1:32 to go. Rahsaan Vanderpool, 9 catches, 207.
It's a career as a tight end. If you're a tight end, that's a career. But then again,
I was going to say, it gives a lot of credit to Mike Jacobs, Nealon, amen. You're the guy. You got to do it. That's all there is to it. You drop two big, big third downs. Now, Johnny Major's club, fellas, we got to respond.
Well, they've had field position. So, Coach Majors, I mean, they have no one to blame because they definitely had some opportunity.
1:32 to go in what has been a beauty. Ryan tried to go deep, had to get free. Underneath, Askew. First down, jumps over, and he's out of bounds at the 38. That play was almost dead. Van Washington comes up to stop him.
Boy, that was ugly. Almost like John wanted to go down and take a sack. Then he said, well, they won't grab me, so I'll keep going with it.
Tell you what, as goofy as this game is, Rahsaan, you may not want to celebrate just yet.
Rahsaan, you better chill out, man.
Minute 23 to go. Five wides. Timeouts remaining, 3 apiece. Bryant got a man down there. It's Askew. Askew is there. Oh, he dropped it. Went right through his hands at the 26. Coverage by Harold Kidd. This has been an explosive game, Doc Walker, and it just isn't over.
Need a playmaker. That's the thing about wide receivers. A lot of guys can catch hitches and outs. You know what I mean? You want to be All-American, you got to get up and take some balls away.
Not only that, all you need is one bonehead trying to be a hero going for a pick, and it's 6 the other way.
It's possible. Love the 5 wide receiver offense that Pitt has employed.
And it's 17 to go. Ryan over the middle. It's caught by Davis. He took himself out of a first down. He may have gotten it back.
The beauty of this sport is that you got to think under tremendous pressure.
You know, you've got to be conscious of down and distance.
Yeah, timeout.
Two timeouts remaining for Pittsburgh.
The Hurts Club.
1:05 to go. And he is about ball length short of a first down, which he would have got an automatic clock
That's
stop.
The point. See, as a receiver, it's your job to know exactly where that marker is. That's the first thing you do. You adjust the route based on the depth it takes to get the first down.
What kind of a play here would you anticipate Johnny Majors and Ken Karcher to try to cook up here?
Well, if you got two timeouts, you could still play maybe one play or so in the middle of the field. West Virginia's going to be looking for those corner routes. You'd like to catch it and get out of bounds, you know, and save it, but you need a big play. No matter what you put up on a blackboard, somebody's got to go up and take the ball away from somebody else. That's how it works. Somebody's got to make a big play. Keep your eye on John Jones. That tight end. Freshman. Right. Yeah, I like the kid a lot, and I think he's due.
87th meeting, backyard brawl. Billy Davis, what a day. 6 catches, 102 yards, fourth receiver, over 100 yards this afternoon for Pitt. In the game for 2-2 for both clubs. Third and short. Ryan, draw, nicely done. Big yardage, he goes down. That'll stop the clock to move the chains. Balls to the 37. David Mayfield makes the stop with help from Emmanuel.
That was a gutsy call. He looked a lot faster than I know he is on that play. It's amazing how fast you can run when you're scared.
Charlie Coe, assistant head coach, running back coach, getting those plays in.
Boy, that was a great call.
Ryan, underneath, Askew, out of room, 25-20, back against the grain, holds on to the ball at the 16.
Yeah, that will hurt you.
Stops the clock again, first down Pitt with 45 seconds to go.
Won't hurt you at all.
I'll say one thing, if they get in the end zone, I know Majors is going for the deuce. No way he's going for the tie.
Oh, no way.
Betting this. I mean, let's eliminate that from consideration right now.
Not when you're hosting the homecoming.
No.
You know.
and three of the dream backfield are here. Yeah. I don't think so. Two injured players down, one for each club.
Combination collision and fatigue.
Pittsburgh had to call a timeout. They have one remaining. Don Nalen's got three left for West Virginia. Medical staffs from both schools out there attending. I want to remind you, Miami, West Virginia, Rutgers, Pitt. I think that Rutgers, BC, and Pitt, Virginia Tech could be on our menu. Join us 12 noon Eastern time. I don't know if you win anything if you pick the right game right now. We can't promise you anything, but hopefully it will be as exciting as today's contest has been, which is approaching, Doc Walker, the four-hour mark.
Yeah, well, my VCR is dead, so.
I did another Pitt game here earlier this year, their opener against Texas. Same type of game, up and down. It was 30-28, and that game went 4 hours plus.
Thanks a lot for telling me now.
Emmanuel was one of the injured players for the Mountaineers.
Been all over the field. He really had. Coach Dunlap, I'm sure he'll find something because he's a coach, but man, their effort has been great. Both of these defensive coordinators really did a fine job and have a lot to be proud of.
This baby's not over.
Oh, no.
45 seconds to go. Pitt kicking, scratching, banging on the door at the West Virginia 17. Five wideouts. They show blitz. They bring it. Ryan finds a man. All over the place. There it is. John Jones, the intended receiver at the five. Doc Walker with another call today where there'll be no stopping this show.
Smoke it, baby. Take me to AC right after this game.
Interference on the defense. Spot foul on running first down.
It's low beam. You got to go to the tight end. You see blitz. There he is. You got a size advantage. He's getting mauled inside.
David Mayfield.
Oh, yeah.
Mayfield all
over him.
If you wanted drama, you got more than a couple bucketfuls today, boy. first and goal for the Pitt Panthers, down 40-33. 41 seconds to go in the backyard brawl. Five flat outs for the Panthers. They may try the old alley-oop, and Eskew, 6'4", top of the screen.
Good idea.
There it is. Eskew cuts the bait.
Dave, you called it. Unfortunately, the PAT is not automatic.
You got that right. Scored a touchdown in his first career catch at Pitt in the West Virginia game back in 1991.
Did the same thing, David.
Here's
first catching college board touchdown.
What a marvelous game. What
Michigan
a marvelous
State,
effort.
Yes.
You did your first game?
Catch, touchdown.
All right, Johnny Majors. Here's a reverse angle.
Hey, you watch
right
this, see? Boy, it's like, just like run and shoot. Run and catch, take a hit in the face, goes back, puts the paws on it, touchdown, Panthers.
The Harold Kidd.
Oh, yeah. Let's watch this again.
Look right
offensive
at
line, Orladini up front, picks up the slant real well. Boy, that's there. That is there. And
40.
You come off the bench as a quarterback. Look at that. Look at that.
And John Ryan putting up all these numbers today in relief of Sean Fitzgerald. A lot of credit to the Pitt defense, but that doesn't mean anything. What happens now is the game.
Yeah.
They've got to score the two-point conversion.
I love this. I love this.
Ryan, 19 for 34, 393 yards, four touchdowns.
Yeah, the tie would get you nothing. Plus, it's not automatic. But it's not even automatic.
That's
here.
That's right.
You know?
Gone for the
deuce.
For this. Davis, Gell, Jay Jones, number 21, another good hands guy, another receiver is playing on the defensive back, is in the game for additional speed.
I like Askew on this.
Davis to the top with Askew, Jones and Gels to the bottom. Pitt went for a deuce last year against Syracuse and didn't get it, trying to run. West Virginia wants to regroup. Don Nealon's club was up 31-6. This game looked like it was over. And that way back in the second period.
How about that 1970 match?
That's right. West Virginia led 35-8 at the half. And Pitt came back to win 36-35. These matchups are just so special.
Well, rivalries, man. It's just
classic rivalry.
And it wouldn't matter if this thing wasn't on TV, if there was nobody here. These guys went out and played it apart. You know, they're going to fight their guts out. We had onsides,
right.
We had blocked punts, we had blocked two-point conversions, we had interceptional two-point conversions,
we had field goal. And I tell you what, the Todd Bork onside kick
classic
should be a primer for everybody for how to and how not to defend it, because West Virginia just peeled and turned, and again, they ran right up the backs and recovered.
I think there's a highlight in this country that will make
off. Here, though, they've worked well with the passing game. Might they try to pull them up, spread them, and then run it?
Yeah. Well, I don't know if you're going to put this on the drive. I think you got to have a run-pass option on this.
Here we go. For the game. Askew in motion. They go with it. Puffy right. Picks the option. Ryan! He got it! Oh, he got it! Pitt takes the lead! Of all people, John Ryan!
One option was there. What an effort.
Unbelievable. The last guy you'd expect to carry it, John Ryan, and that's why it worked.
Well, when you got Billy West in the backfield, you have got to honor it. Because he runs so well. You know, let's put you in quarterback right now. First of all, get that snap. You get the snap, you got the read. You fake the call. Hey, you know, you expect Mason to do that, serves you. If you expect that from John Ryan, hit it, Pitt.
That is outstanding.
Here's the key. Ryan's got to be the most valuable player. He almost stumbles, but he dives and gets it in there. That's for the money.
And West Virginia had the pitch man shut down. Matt Tofoni was all over Billy West.
Boy.
Again, we said we had the shot of Vanderpool, don't celebrate too soon. Same goes for Pitt with 38 seconds
good
to
point.
Go.
Good point. But, you know, again, if you're playing a team that runs the option well, that runs it a lot, if Mason of Syracuse is with this, you're in a world of trouble. You don't expect Ryan to do it. How do you take this guy out of the starting lineup now? I don't know if you do.
Two timeouts remaining for West Virginia. John Ryan no matter the outcome of this game, has certainly established himself in pit lore now, coming off the bench to lead this comeback.
Hard not to play the kid. He's a Spartan. He's got a win that can pick a program up.
Here's another thing to think about that Don Nalen has in his arsenal. His long-distance field goal kicker is Todd Sauerbrunn.
Oh, my goodness. You're right. That's an ugly thought. All they got to do is be with about 70 yards in.
Sauerbrunn had his 0-for-1. The attempt was plus 50 yards.
See, I think you boom this one. You get it out, and you cover it.
Todd Martin will kick it. This has been a magnificent contest. 41-40 Pitt. He booms it. 38 seconds. Vanderpool at the goal line. To the 10. Finds a hole. To
wow.
the 27.
That's a great return.
Mountaineers have two times out remaining. 32 seconds to go. Kid Beasley, the defensive unit, they can't believe that Pitt went down the field and scored.
Oh, it's Sauerbrunn. You can play this a couple of ways. One for the field goal, or one to see if you can break one. If it was a Miami Dolphins, you know you get that hitch and pitch.
Vanderpool in the slot to the top of your screen. Minifield outside him. Johnston steps up. What a run. Does the smart thing and gets out of bounds at about the 42-yard line.
Oh, that's great play. Great play by Chad on that. Boy, if you get sacked at that point, still got two TOs, man, but you don't want to use them.
24 seconds to go in as exciting a game as I've ever been associated
with. Oh, this is numero uno. Keep your eye on 67, John McCray.
24 seconds to go. Johnston. The running game, Tyler Young forces him. He's got a man down the sideline.
Oh, he's got it! He's got it! Touchdown, West Virginia! Zach Abraham and the Mountaineers are back on top with 15 seconds to go.
Oh, my goodness. How in the world do you let a guy get it back at you with this kind of time on the clock? What are you thinking? You're in a semi-prevent defense. Man.
I don't believe it. Are you kidding me? 60 yards on the play to Zach Abraham. Six catches, a 179, two touchdowns.
Good stunt up front. Boy, you got to give Chad some credit on that. He stepped up in the pocket, and it's like Mosley was thinking, oh, he's going to be sacked. Hey, man, you got to play the defense. College football, big time.
Bauman's kick is good.
This is not the game of the entire day, and I'll jump out of this booth.
I'm telling you, Auburn may have won in Florida, but this is the game of the day.
Oh, yeah, yeah. This is it. Oh, boy. It all starts once again with the offensive line up front. Pretty good protection. He steps up in the pocket. You think he's down. And, boy, he throws that on the run. Got a little duck to it. But it's there. You just don't let it happen. You take the pass interference, you do whatever it takes.
Two plays, 72 yards, 23 seconds for West Virginia.
Boy. Oh, man. I'm too old for this kind of stuff.
Well, if you weren't, you are now.
Still got time. Still time on the bed.
I'm telling you. I said it. I've already said it twice. And, you know, don't celebrate too early. Johnston, I may get out of here with a voice after this.
Who may get the last lap.
16 for 36 for Johnston. 397 yards and four touchdowns.
Boy, I think it's better. It's a sweeter win if you're on the road. For a road team to come into this pit and make this happen in those circumstances, truly incredible. Try to build a program. Coach Majors understands.
790 yards passing on the afternoon combined by these two clubs. Johnny Major saying, make them kick it again.
Yeah, I don't know why you kicked it out of bounds.
Yeah, really. I'm telling you, this has been amazing. Johnston's thrown for 397, Ryan for 393. Total of 790.
And ticking. Still going, man. This thing is still going, still alive.
4 hours and change here at Pitt Stadium. 38,000 have seen this game, which will be remembered for a very long time. 38,293. Don Nealon, again, his club was up 31-6. What time's the bus back to Morgantown, right?
I don't know. It'll just float back. It'll float back. This is why you coach. These are the games, man.
Been more peaks and valleys in this game. And how do you figure Pittsburgh's defense completely shuts down West Virginia in the second half, and then they give it up twice?
Yeah, until it counts.
They let it roll through the end zone, and they have to just down it there, and that's what they're going to do. Boy, Al Hines with a quick whistle as Jay Jones fields it, and Pittsburgh will put it in play with 15 seconds to go.
And you can still get a bomb, a pass interference. I mean, we still, yeah, two plays if you come out and execute properly.
Pittsburgh! The Pittsburgh ball!
Just think if you decided not to come to this one, you know, you'd be kicking yourself.
Seconds to go. West Virginia, everybody back. It's hung up. Gels is there. And it's an incompletion. At the 45 of the Mountaineers. There's been more ebb and flow to this game than I've seen in many, many, many years.
Oh, this is a classic. This
and
is
we
what
thought
you wait for.
With Ryan, of all people, two-point conversion, what better period to this game? But, you know, when you think that, that's glad I got triple zeros up in the clock. That's when the game's over. 8 seconds to go. This is probably going to do it here. Ryan throws it high and far. Beasley's there. Washington's there. It's caught. You believe that?
He's got it.
Gels got it. Time runs out at the 38. The game is over. And our player of the game is Zach Abraham, who had a fabulous game. 6 catches, 179 yards, and a game-winning touchdown to win it 47-41 for West Virginia. What a game. For Doc Walker, I'm Dave Sims. And our entire Big East crew, thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week. The final, West Virginia 47, Pittsburgh 41. Has been a Big East Television Network production. Good afternoon, everyone.
Today against the Owls of Temple.